Hey everyone, I just wanted to do a video to follow up on yesterday's video where I talked about how Reagan was assaulted by the media for his entire time, for his entire 8 years. It never ended. They beat on the man from day one until his final day in office. And I suggested that that is exactly what we're going to be looking at for the next 4 or hopefully 8 years with Donald Trump. And I want to point out something today that that I didn't touch on very much yesterday, and that is that, believe it or not, the biggest obstacle we are going to face is going to be from the Republicans in Congress. Now, I know that common sense, for those of us who have some, would be looking at the situation and thinking, well, the Republicans in Congress clearly saw how Donald Trump had this message for the working class in America, and they really bought into it. And so, to be successful, they should have learned from Donald Trump, and now they really know what the working class in America would really like to do. They would like to see an end to globalism, to the free trade, so-called free trade, bad trade deals, essentially, is what they are. They would like to see an end to the open borders. They would like to see some fiscal sanity. They are sick and tired of being taxed and regulated to death. And these are all the things that Donald Trump talked about, which played very well for him and allowed him to defeat all those Republican candidates in the primary and then go on and defeat Hillary Clinton pretty handily in the Electoral College and win the presidency. Now, all this stuff that's going on right now, as I mentioned yesterday, is just a distraction. The electoral electors are not going to support him, or you know, Putin hacked in the election. This is all just nonsense. Donald Trump is going to be inaugurated and sworn in on January the 20th. None of that stuff is going to stick, and they know it. This is just simply to try to delegitimize Trump and paralyze him so that he can't move forward with his agenda. This is all that that's about. But the thing that we need to pay very close attention to is it's not the Democrats. I mean, they are going to fight Donald Trump every step of the way, the entire time he's president, along with their friends in the media. This is to be expected. We should understand that and accept that. That's common sense. But the real issue that we have to deal with is that there is going to be many in the Congress who publicly are going to stand out there and say, yeah, we want to work with Trump and try to make America great again and have an aggressive legislative session and do a lot of good things for the working class in this country. But they don't really mean it. They're still the same exact corporate hacks, bought and paid for, owned by lobbyists. It's the same crew. And they have other interests. They've never had our interest at heart. Otherwise, these things would have been done a long time ago. You see, they're not on our team, and they sure as hell are not on Donald Trump's team. The Republicans in Congress, for the most part, there'll be a few who will hang with him, but for the most part, they are going to fight him, and it won't necessarily be out in the public eye. They'll do it behind closed doors. They'll go out in public and say one thing, but behind closed doors, they'll be manipulating things in order to sabotage Trump's agenda. You can mark my words on this. This is exactly what we're going to see. So we have a few weeks to take a little breather and allow this stuff to play out. As I said, Donald Trump's going to be inaugurated. None of this stuff that you see that's being thrown out there is going to amount to a hill of beans. It's just a campaign to discredit him. Okay, so once we get to Trump being sworn in, and he begins, especially in the first 100 days, to implement his agenda, whether it's building the wall, renegotiating trade deals, whatever it may be, expect that our biggest enemies, our biggest adversaries, are going to be the Republicans in Congress. So what we need to do, and this is something that will require a focused effort, with all of us partaking in this effort, make YouTube videos, send them to your friends on Facebook, use the social media. We have to stay on top of these Republicans, and whenever some of them fall out of line, we have to make absolutely sure that we contact them, whether it's on their Facebook pages, on their Twitters, whether it's phone calls. You can send emails, but I've found that emails having sent hundreds and hundreds of emails to my congressman, are really not that effective. Maybe just before an election they look at that, but right after an election or something like that, they really don't pay too much attention. And you can tell because you'll send them an email about a specific gripe that you have, and what you'll get back is a standard general email, sort of a thank you for contacting your congressman, blah 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 blah, and then it's a bunch of BS. Never actually addresses your question at all because they don't actually read your emails. Your email comes in, it automatically triggers a response back to you. They don't even read it. They just write to the shit can. They never read your emails, okay? Now, they do have to take your phone calls, and they have offices both in Washington and in their home district. And when you get their aides on the phone, their aides will generally not fight you. They will not try to argue with you. They will generally hear you out. They'll generally give you about 5 minutes to air your grievance, and then they will say something nice. They won't necessarily agree with you, but they won't fight with you, and they won't make any promises or suggest what the congressman will or will not do. They'll just simply allow you to vent. So I think phone calls, although it's a little more of a hassle than an email, is far more effective. And we're gonna have to burn their phone lines up, and we'll need to target those people, those specific Republicans. Some of them are named Mitch McConnell. We'll need to target these types of people because, and John McCain, Lindsey Graham, these will be the types of people we'll need to target because they will be the ones trying to sabotage the effort to restore America to some sense of fairness, equality, and real capitalism. So this is the message I have today, is go ahead and enjoy this little breather that we have for the next few weeks. But once Inauguration Day happens and Trump is sworn in and he gets ready to move forward on the agenda, we're going to be back in a full bare-knuckle fight with our own party, the Republicans. That's who our adversaries really are. They're the ones that we're going to be in combat with, verbal combat. So prepare yourselves for what's coming and get prepared to get back in the fight, because it'd be nice if we could just win the election and then go back to our lives and allow Trump to move forward. But believe me, we're gonna have to fight and scratch for every single thing we get, whether it's the wall, renegotiating trade deals, you name it, whatever it is, tax cuts. It's going to be a battle on every front, on every issue, the entire way out. So we're going to have to prepare ourselves to engage in this verbal combat, political combat. And the way to do it, again, is when these so-called Republicans, so-called conservatives, begin to thwart the effort to make America great again, that's when we have to engage them heavy. We have to put some fear in them. And the way to do that is to jump all over them when they come out and throw a wrench in the spokes. And so prepare yourself. This is what we're going to be doing. This is how we're going to get things done. And it's the only way we're going to get things done. Excuse me. It's going to require a major effort on all of our parts. So enjoy a few weeks off. Get ready for combat. It's coming. And if you like this video, please share this video with your friends and social media. Give me a like if you like the video. I love your comments always. And subscribe to my channel if you like, because I try to do at least one video every day. Hopefully we can work together with President-elect Trump to move forward, implement the agenda that we all know we need to implement to restore this country back to a free market capitalist system that benefits everyone, from the poor all the way up to the wealthy. There's plenty to go around. It's just the corruption has got to end. And it's going to be up to us to do it. We finally have a guy at the top who will make it happen. So we actually might see some results for all the efforts that we are going to have to make. So hang in there and let's get it done. See y'all.